just coming alongside of Ellington, Connecticut, in the auto chains monster car, 132.
JNS Industrial Repair, place car number 23. The whisker driver behind the wheel is Mark Caruso.
One of the veterans is back. He provides an odd number 42, another auto chains monster car from Preston, Connecticut, Jay Stewart.
This driver's been around the block a few times as well, in car number 78 from Berlin, in the Lucky Rock Horse monster car, Paul Recchio Jr.
This guy's taste of the sweets of victories in a championship.
Stafford's place, it's pretty pit cat.
Brian Pasacco behind the wheel of car 71. Peter Portillo. Top 10. Ben Michael Costello with car 18. Trouble for sure, right? It's like it's crazy to be able to go to the outside. Those are some tough positions. And they also brought down Peter Portillo. And Ryan Pasacco will have the lead after the first lap. Oh, boy. Car goes to the left. Stuck the end of the road.
Yeah.
Sure, and he's a nice guy. He looks like one of those rough and tough guys, but when you get to talk to him, he really is just a big teddy bear kind of guy.
It looks like a cast member of the Sopranos.
Yes, he does. He's always got a toothpick hanging out of his mouth to give him that tough guy look and so forth. But let's see what's going to happen now. Keep your eyes on Doug Coby. He hasn't had a lot of time to practice with this car. You know, Doug Coby, he doesn't need practice. He's like Keith Rocco. It all comes so natural. Green flag is out off turn number four, and Bosso is the man. J.J. Hill, with a new color paint scheme on the car, that blue is the story there, and we're going to have that for a third minute.
And in the middle of that action on the outside, Jim Peterson said he had a great car after practice yesterday, so Peterson cruising along in third, the battle with the big fourth and fifth between Tommy Ford on the outside, and it is him talking his eager hand on the car.
Returns to the competition last year, and he says that now his car is stronger than better than ever. The Ram now tries to muscle his way underneath Fern, and the car come together like two symbols of an orchestra, but they're okay now. And it looks like
and he looked like a belly dancer returning before as he wiggled and Fern was able to get underneath him to win with the number four position. Things are about to get heated at the front. Monticello has had things his own way for the first portion of this race, but now turning down his tailpipe is J.J. Hill and making it a four-way battle for the top spot, Jim Peterson and Tommy Ford.
Tommy Ford just gave him a little smooch down the front straightaway, lets him know he's there, and now Ford will move to the inside of Jim Peterson. They brought that over, they head down into turn number three. Ford is into the third spot. Doug Coby pulls out with car number seven. Tommy Ford is a man with a mission. He's coming to the front. Peterson sitting in that third spot back. And meanwhile, J.J. Hill made a bid for Monticello to try to take over position number one.
As J.J. Hill is on that back bumper like a kid sticking out of a birthday cake, looking for some room as he tries to scurry his way down against Monticello. But Monticello, he knows how to protect his turf, and he is doing a good job of doing that. Making some noise is Tommy Ford, but the straw that stirs the drink right now is J.J. Hill.
Down the backstretch, Hill dives to the inside, can't do it. Monticello shuts the door, red versus blue, a little black in there for black and blue, and that's what they're doing. They're bumping a little bit as they come off the turn. That's the way this moves to so that most people park here at Stafford. Off turn number two, leader is still Monticello. Hill is still in second, Ford is still third, Peterson is third. McCart is five and Duran is six. Single file, they come to the line. Matt, is anybody going to make a move with less than one lap to go?
But Monticello will have to sweat it out for one more lap. We saw J.J. Hill try to put some marks on the back bumper, but he couldn't get underneath the 28 coming out of turn number two. Turn number three, the man still looking pretty strong. Still, it's Dennis Monticello.
No question about it. Off turn number four, back to the line they come, and Monticello has the victory. J.J. Hill in for second.
Lights come off on the safety vehicle, late model showtime, full fender Wednesday, about to be unleashed. Here's Matt Bucker with a call as they head on turn four.
J.J. Hill gets a 16-year-old Peter Portete. Hill gets a thrill early on as he will be
he busted his way and what he did, yeah, he's busted.
I trust her. She knows what I'm thinking before I even think it. And that's, of course, a combination that only a husband and wife can have. She's passionate about motorsport, and they're excited that they've got two cars out on the racetrack. But her focus is on her husband, from a spotter stand and pedal diligence.
Well, it's a good choice, and it is an honest choice to say the least. But
I've heard Patty talk about auto racing. She knows her stuff.
She sure does.
She's a car racer. She's had some serious damage to her car.
Thank you.
Thank you.